Gordy must be up here somewhere. Shouldn't be too hard. Have to admit, he's really impressed me. Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the origami killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw it. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
I don't know why, but your story just doesn't check out. You've given me the crap. Now, tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the origami killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
Now where am I supposed to go? There must be a clue or something. What the hell am I supposed to do here? This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. The origami figure was in the form of a butterfly. So, am I looking for a butterfly? The main entrance is blocked up. There must be another entrance somewhere. There's got to be a way into the building. You might be able to find an entrance if I go around the building. Barbed wire. There must be a way through. Electrical condensers. Going by the sound of them, they're still active. It might be a trap. I'd better be careful. glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. My vision's getting blurry. Easy does it. I've got to move slowly, or I'm gonna faint. Don't even know where it leads. Could lead to hell for all I know. Whatever, I don't really have a choice. There's no other way out. To jump or not to jump. Fuck that. Keep it together, Ethan. Come on! Right. I guess I don't really have any choice.
Oh my God. Ethan, can you hear me? Look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds. Are those burn marks on your chest? I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. You've got a hell of a fever. Those are serious burns. I don't know if I can do anything for you. Doctor, but I'll do what I can. Infected. Not terribly good for burns. Your wounds are disinfected. Can't put on a bandage yet. Gotta treat the wounds first. That should ease the pain. That's all I can do. How do you feel? Ethan? He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait and hope he wakes up. How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
You didn't really leave me any choice. I couldn't just leave you like that.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but it's not easy. You got some kind of a problem?
Bigger than you can possibly imagine.
You mixed up with the mafia? Owe someone money? Something like that?